Hello and welcome to the seventh video in this series for 24-Hour Answers, where we learn to be a better programmer. This time, since we've previously covered many of the basics of the C programming language, I've decided to take you through actually creating a program from scratch. To do this, I've written a small assignment. The assignment is to create an interest calculator. The program should take a user's name, total savings, and savings account interest rate, and calculate how much interest they will earn before tax after a number of years entered. The program will then ask the user if they want to run another calculation and respond accordingly. So the very first thing you need to do is actually create your solution. Now for all of this, I'm assuming that you're using Visual Studio, although of course there are other environments that you may use. So here we want to create a new project. In this case, we want to use a console application for Visual C++. So we enter a name for this project. I'll just call it Interest Calculator. And we create a directory, etc. And this will open up this application wizard, which you may have seen before if you're trying to follow along with any of these tutorials. Now, I think you want to use empty project for all of these, simply so that you don't get some non-standard elements supplied by Visual Studio. Again, we still want a console application, Windows application, much more advanced, and we'll probably cover it much later on in the series. So I'm going to click Finish, and Visual Studio will create, as I say, an empty solution. So we can look in the Solution Explorer here, and we can see that we've got folders for header files, source files, and so on. Nothing in any of those yet. So the first thing we want to do is go ahead and add a new item, which is a C++ file, to the source folder. And I'll just call this Calculator. And this is the file which will hold our main method. So now, of course, we want to actually create our main method. In this case, we'll just skip any parameters. And now we should probably refer back to our assignment. So the first point here is to make note of all of the inputs that the program needs to take. So here we've got username, total savings, interest rate, and number of years. The other interesting factor here is that we want to do all this within a loop, and the evidence that this is the case comes from the line, the program will then ask the user if they want to run another calculation and respond accordingly. So we can actually put the loop part in last, and just first of all create the program to handle one run through. So first of all, we should create variables for each of these. So we want to be able to have a username, and total savings, interest rate. We'll go ahead and use floats for these, even though if you remember from previous videos, I've told you not to do that. It's just a bit easier here. So the total savings, interest rate, and the last of these is the number of years, which is obviously an integer. So now that we've declared all these up front, we don't have to worry about doing so later on. So since we now want to start capturing input, it's probably best to give the user an idea of what we want them to do. So here we want to display a message to the user. Obviously from this point, let me just make this a bit larger, we can start capturing input. Now you'll see here an error, printf is undefined. If you remember back, the reason for this is that we haven't got any includes. I'm just preloading these, as it were, because I know I'm going to use all of them. We've actually covered all of these before. Con.io has the getch method. Standard input output and standard library just contain all the methods that we need. So please enter your name with a new line. The next point is we actually want to put the user's name into the username variable. So actually you'll notice up here we haven't actually initialized any of these variables, which could come back to cause problems for us. So again, I used this in tutorial 6. you've seen me do this before as well. Same here. And number of years we can set to 1 quite safely. So now we want to put some input into the username variable. So for this, you might remember, we need to use a method called fgets. And the first variable that we need is the variable we're putting, the first argument that we need is the variable into which we want to put our input, username. Then we want to know the size. Well, it's 100 here because that's the size of the username array. And lastly, we need standard input to tell the program that we want to read from standard input. At this point, it's probably safest to call rewind. Essentially, this saves your program getting too confused about which input's going in when new lines happen and so on. So that's our first variable entered. The next thing we want to fill in is the total savings. And this time we're dealing with a float. So if you remember correctly, we can use scanf(s) and we pass into this an indicator of the format that we want to use. Oops. And the and symbol with the number we want to pass in and have populated by this method. You can actually copy paste this code for the interest rate. And then finally we want to know the number of years. A bit of a new line there. Oops, semicolon missing on that line. And so here we want to call scanf(s), this time with %d. And we want to put the number into, what did I call that variable, number of years. So at this point we can assume that all of these variables have been filled in, so we can start to print the output. But first of all, we might want to calculate the amount of money generated. So one way to do this is to declare a float, which is, just call it money, and we'll set that to total savings. And then we can create a for loop, and this loop can go through the number of years. So we make a counter which we call i is equal to 1 for as long as I is less than number of years and I goes up by 1 each time. We want to increase the amount in total savings, the amount in money. We add to that, so that's plus equals, or if you prefer we can simply say money equals money. And then we want to add, what do we want to add? The amount of interest that someone will gain in 1 year. So this is going to be money, because money is going to be growing each time. We want to say increase it by the amount that we had at the previous year by the interest rate. So money is equal to money plus, and then we open brackets to make a sub clause of our sum. And we want to multiply the interest rate, which is going to be something like 3.2, divided by 100, times money. So you can put this in brackets again, just to make it clearer. And that should give us, if we entered all of our variables correctly, the new value. So at this point, we want to give the user their output. Username. And I'll just write this quickly to get the format of it. Input savings. Interest earned. New value of savings. I might say after however many years. This is number of years. Just to make the input more meaningful to the user, here, of course, we want username. Here we want the actual savings themselves. So that's total savings. Interest earned after these years is going to be money. The new value of savings, oh no, sorry, this is going to be money minus the input. Because obviously money has the total after all these years have elapsed. The new value of savings is money.